Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jayamudirai Nashtaprayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtaki Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha Nanda Gopakumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Namom Vishnupadaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratvishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam Canto 11, Chapter 26, Text Number 18. Kindly repeat after me. Kwayam Malimasakayo Dorgandhyatmako Suchihi Kwagunaha Saumanasadhyā Yadhyaso Vidhyakrita Kwayam Malimasakayo Dorgandhyatmako Suchihi Kwagunaha Saumanasadhyā Hi Adhyaso Vidhyakrita Kwayam Malimasakayo Dorgandhyatmako Suchihi Kagunaha Saumanasadhyā Hi Adhyaso Vidhyakrita
ततः वायं मलिमसहकायो कौमध्यात्मको शुचिः यद्यासो विद्यया
माताजी
कायं मलिमसहकायो
Kwa, where, I am, this, malimasaha, very filthy, kayaha, material body, durgandhya, bad odor, adi, and so on, atmakaha, consisting of, asuchi, unclean, kwa, where, gunaha, the so-called good qualities. Saumanasya, the fragrance and tenderness of flower. Adhyaha, and so on. He, certainly. Adhyasaha, the superficial impositions. Avidyayaha, by ignorance, kritaha, created. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation, what is this polluted body anyway? So filthy and full of bad odors. I was attracted by the fragrance and beauty of a woman's body. But what are those so-called attractive features? They are simply a false covering created by illusion. Purport. Pururava now understands that although he was madly attracted to the fragrant, shapely body of Urvasi. In fact, that body was a sack of stool, gas, bile, mucus, hairs, and other repugnant elements. In other words, Pururava is now becoming sane. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim yat kripatam aham vande sri guru dinatarinam sri chaitanya ishwaram paramananda madhavam asaduna sadutadain atinichochatakara anamum chakadachin premnamatakantavyaspura. Hare Krishna. So I seek blessings of all the assembled Vaishnavas so that I can speak something on this interesting chapter. The Ailagit, which is spoken by Lord Krishna himself. This is the story, or this is the song which Lord Krishna himself is singing. This song is talking about, the story is demonstrating Aila and Pururava and Urvashi. The story demonstrates a state of bewilderment to the state of enlightenment. This story demonstrates that the power of illusion and the power of illumination. This story demonstrates who is the real controller? Who rules the world? Where a conqueror becomes conquered. So who is the real ruler of this world? And this is what Asatyara Satya Karimani. The story of Asatyara Satya Karimani. Yesterday we celebrated Nityanand Trayodashi. And Lochandas Thakur talks about this. I am enjoying this world, thinking this as a real thing. But it is illusory. Asatyara Satya Karimani and Satyara Asatya Karimani. This is the state of living entity. And how devotional service changes Asatya to Asatya and Satya to Satya. So this is the story about this personality. It is interesting to understand that the world, whole world revolves around this www.com, World Wide Web. Everyone has been caught up in this net of web. Here, Lord Krishna is demonstrating this song. This www stands for three important things of a living entity, which he revolves around. The first is, first W stand for wealth. Second W stand for woman. And third W stand for worship. If you see, what you get on the net is these three things only. How to earn, how to make money, how to get sense object, woman. That is, woman is man, for man, woman, and woman is a man. Like, man is woman for woman. That is what. So that is woman referred to. And worship means getting worshipped. And that is what net offers all of us, isn't it? What is this Facebook, Instagram, and all this thing? Where you want worshippers. Where you are looking for worshippers. So that people can worship you. And therefore people are so absorbed. How shall I make my status? How shall I look good? How shall I talk better? So that I can get worshipper. And these three things, Lord Krishna is, that illusion, Lord Krishna is destroying. So in Bhikshu Git, earlier the Lord sung that song, where a Brahmana from Avanti Desh, who was having so much of wealth, how he got disgusted, how that wealth destroyed all his illusion when it is taken away. So that Lord Krishna demonstrated through that song, that how wealth can create trouble. So that was the Bhikshu Git. That is wealth, W. And the second here, in this song, Lord Krishna is demonstrating through King Pururava that how a sense object is illusory, which we think can give us a lot of enjoyment, the same can give you unlimited suffering. And in previous chapter, which is not a song, but how he, about worship. Actually, the creation of Urvashi, where we are going to talk about, the creation of Urvashi through Lord only, means she got her birth from Lord himself. And Brahmaji was created by Lord, and Urvashi was also created by Lord. She came from the Lord's thigh, therefore her name is Urvashi. So through creating Urvashi, Lord destroyed the pride of demigods, means worshipper. They have been worshipped by people all around. But creating Urvashi, by creating that Urvashi, Lord destroyed the false pride of all the demigods. So Lord Krishna is demonstrating through all this thing how this www.com is so illusory. And we should not get caught up in the net of this www.com. Wealth, woman, and worship. So that is this song is, and that what we are going to discuss today. My theme is five senses, five traps, and five realizations. So I'm going to talk on this theme. While in the ninth canto, when Sukhdev Goswami was narrating this story to King Parikshit Maharaj, he finished talking about Surya Vamsha, the great dynasty of sun god. How heroic kings appeared in that dynasty. And then he started talking about moon dynasty, Chandra Vamsha. Atha
Athaya ayata shruyatam rajan vamsha somasya pavanah yasmin nailadayo bhupa kirtante punya kirtayah.
That the description mentions kings like Aila, means Pururava, of whom it is glorious to hear. So when Shukadeva Goswami narrates this story in 9th canto, it is interesting. Means he talks about that hearing about such king like Aila and Pururava is very glorious, is purifying. Kirtayaha, kirtante punya kirtayaha, is very auspicious. Iske baare mein sunna, matlab, bahut sari bhakti ko arjan karna. Punya kirtayaha. And when Shukadeva Goswami describes the story of King Pururava, devotee gets bewildered. Here, what is this? That means the end of the story is very interesting, where Shukadeva Goswami finishes. Shukadeva Goswami finishes saying that how King Pururava fell into, means he got fall into, like he fell into love of Urvashi, and then Urvashi left him. He was searching for her, and after she was not available, he worshipped Gandharvas. And after worshipping Gandharvas, he went back to the place where Urvashi is residing. And chapter ends there. So he goes to Gandharva Loka. So somebody might be thinking, here, what is this? Means he went to Gandharva Loka, where is the going back home, back to Godhead? After all, he received what he wanted. So why not look for that? But no, the revelation of that personality is come across in the 11th canto. We come across about that. And here Lord Krishna is singing his glory. What happened after he reached Gandharva Loka? Or where he met his desired sense object? And that became the glorious thing, where Lord Krishna himself is singing his glories. And therefore, hearing about Aila or hearing about Pururava is Punya Kirtaya. Although we heard that story, it was in kind of like, it was incomplete. What happened after that? Somebody might think, oh, that was the happy ending. Ki usko jo chahiye tha, wo mil gaya. But no, what happened after he got that? That is the most important thing. Whether you come to the realization or whether you go or enter into the illusion. So Pururava, Maharaj Pururava, he received that realization, and therefore Lord Krishna is singing his glories. And therefore his story is Punya Kirtayaha. Kirtante Punya Kirtayaha. Therefore it is very glorious. So it is said that means in this story, it's like Pururava is a, just see the personality. He is the son of the most intelligent person. He is the son of King Buddha. Means he is a planetary. Anyone who is having intelligence is called Buddhiwan. He is the son of a Buddha and Ila. So in his life, everything was going fine, isn't it? Means he was conqueror, chakravarti. But somehow or other, Urvashi comes in his life. He didn't go there in heavenly planet. Urvashi came hearing his glories. So it is said that the wrong people finds you when you are in a peace and leaves you in pieces. And the right person finds you in pieces and leads you to peace. That is devotee. So things were going fine in his life. But somehow or other, she comes in his life and the course changes. And another thing is about Urvashi. It is Bhagavatam says that if somebody wants good wife, agar kisi ko achhi patni chahiye, to he should worship Urvashi. He can receive. And what has been said here, that Pururava Maharaj received her. Huh? So
how good she must be. So everyone is looking for some perfect person, isn't it? Ekdam, what I want. Perfect relationship. So here is the perfect match. And one boy went to a baba. He saw that advertisement in the railway. That man chahi, cheez aapko mil jayegi. 100% guarantee. So he went to that person. Baba. Baba became very happy. Like, what? Arre. The boy said, Baba. Baba asked him, what do you want? Kya chahiye tumko? Bole, I want a wife. Mujhe patni chahiye. Bole, acha. Kaisi? To bole, jo sundar ho. Jo shushil ho. Jo meri baat sune. Jo meri seva kare. Aur mere kehne par hi chale. To Baba said, Baba, main kuch asli cheez mango. Main vehm ko pura nahi karta. So everyone wants some perfect thing in life, but even after receiving perfection, what do you get? So that is what is demonstrated through this story, that perfect match, everything going fine. But what is happening? Lamentation, suffering. So we cannot avoid this thing. That she has been created, as I was telling you, that she has been created by Lord Krishna himself. And Narayan Rishi, when he was performing tapasya, Indra got scared that, aray, he might occupy my seat. So he sent few apsara from his heavenly planet. But he misunderstood the personality whom he was dealing with. So Lord Krishna said, aray, he sent me, he is a Madan Mohan. He can even captured the Cupid. So Lord said, okay, you are sending this toys. So lay. He created another toy, which he got bewildered with. And Urvashi became the prominent, one of the leading consort, leading nymph, you can say, in heavenly planet. So Krishna, Kapildev, in third canto, he says that, Balam me pascha mayaya, Sri maya jaino disham, Yakaroti Pradakranta Bruvi Jrimbena Kevalam. Just see the power of my illusory energy. She can conquer just by the eyebrows. Just eyebrow uthali. So just everyone can be conquered. So just when Krishna is not dealing directly with the creation, so she can create such a big thing. Or he can create such a big thing. What to speak of Lord Krishna, who himself has created Urvashi? How much trouble or how much things she can conquer? And Bhagavatam talks about so many things, in so many incidences. Bhagavatam talks about Urvashi's beauty. And how many they got conquered by her. Except one personality, that is Arjuna. Means he was like a creator only, Narayan Rishi. Arjuna is Nara only. So he did not get conquered. But everyone else got conquered. So whenever, like, if we want to enjoy Krishna's creation, Urvashi is Krishna's creation. So it comes with the conditions and restrictions. Krishna's creation, if we want to enjoy, that comes with conditions and restrictions. She came in life of Pururava, but with the conditions. She told, these three things, if you continue following, till that time I will be with you. Once it is over, or any one of this is broken, I will go back. So she came with the conditions. And there are so many restrictions. So what happens when such thing comes in life? When we want to enjoy Krishna's creation, it brings only frustration. But when we want to enjoy with Krishna, keeping Krishna in the center, then the same thing, same creation becomes the source of illumination. So here, Pururava Maharaj is talking about, if you see the second line, Daurgandhya Adi Atmako Asuchi, that the body full of bad odors and consisting of unclean things. And in the ninth canto, exactly opposite has been spoken. When Pururava saw Urvashi, Devi Urvashi, there it has been written, Ramamanastaya Devya Padma Kinjalka Gandhaya. Padma Kinjalka Gandhaya. Dekho, Daurgandhya, now he is using the word Daurgandhya, where he is in the heavenly planet, in Gandharva Loka, where the body is itself fragrant. No external things required to make your body fragrant. There he is saying, Daurgandhya Atma Ko Asuchihi is unclean and full of bad odor. And in this material world, where the body itself is a full of bad odor, what he was thinking? Padma Kinjalka Gandhaya. Padma Kinjalka Gandhaya means the smell of flower of lotus flower. So Kinjalka, Kinjalka Gandhaya. So this is what, you know, in illusion, even a Daurgandhya looks Sugandha. And in illumination, whether it is Sugandha or not, it is a Daurgandhya. And that is what happened here. In the heavenly planet, he is realizing that even this fragrant body, it is a Daurgandhya only. So Srimad Bhagavatam is trying to break our illusion. And world is trying to create bigger and bigger illusion. And what out of this all advertisement is? Advertisement is just creating illusion about yourself and your body. That they promote how you can enjoy as much as you can and as long as you can. But here, Bhagavatam is trying to break that illusion. So the about whom he is talking? He is talking about Urvashi, who is a heavenly damsel. So what to speak of insignificant heroine, heroines where people get enamored about? Huh? Who makes the advertisement? And Brajbhair Prabhu, once in his Bhagavatam class, he was giving this example. One of the well-known Bollywood hero, he married to a very beautiful lady of that time. And the next day, his illusion was destroyed when she went for Pratavidhi. So he became bewildered. Well, what is this? So the illusion get destroyed when we come across reality. But even after hearing, our senses keeps getting distracted. Patanga matanga kurunga bringa meena hata pancha bireva pancha eka pramati katham nahanyate yasevate pancha bireva pancha. Patanga matanga kurunga bringa. This shloka is talking about five animals, that how they get trapped through five senses. That these animals, they are a bit negligent with their one sense. We all have five senses. Body is consisting of five senses. And five senses keep distracting us. So here, Patanga is a moth. He gets attracted to the flame and he loses his life. Matanga is elephant. He gets touch. Because of touch, he gets distracted and gets trapped. Then Bringa is a bumblebee. He's a powerful to even go through the wood, but he gets trapped in the flower and dies. Bringa. Then Kuranga is a deer. Deer is very fast in moving. But when deer hears the sweet melodious song, immediately stops and loses his life. And Meena means fish, because of tongue, it gets trapped. So Bhagavatam talks about five powerful people that one sense went astray and they get trapped. So Bhagavatam talks about story of Maharaj Shantanu. He got attracted because of fragrance. That is the first thing. Second, Urvashi. If you see, Urvashi, she is a heavenly damsel. She was ready to come down to the earth. Upar ka chodke niche. Why? She heard the glories of Pururava. Hearing. Hearing created trap for her. Pururava Maharaj. Everything was going fine, but when he saw Urvashi, eyes. When he saw, he forgot everything. Then, another thing is about Yayati Maharaj. He was also ruling the world, emperor, but he caught hold of a Devayani, and just 1 second more than what is required, he got entangled with her. And the fifth one is Shobari Muni. Shobari Muni was performing tapasya underwater. But he saw Meena, means fishes, tasting Adharamrita. So he got distracted because of that. So this is the Bhagavatam is demonstrating this, that if one sense of a human being is not carefully guarded, it can create such a big trouble in life. So what to speak of a living entity whose five senses are running in five directions, which is trying to satisfy. So it's very clearly demonstrated, and that is what, therefore, here, the realizations of Maharaj Pururava is very significant. Dehanavarutseham dukkashok bhayavaham sarvatrasya yato mrityur matsyana mudake yatha. So what is this body which we are looking to fulfill all its demands? Dukkha shok bhayahavam. What is this body is bringing? Dukkha means misery, suffering. Shoka, lamentation. And bhayavaham. Bhayavaham means fear. It's creating fear. And what is that? Overall, after all this thing, what has been said? That sarvatrase yato mrityur. And every time living entity is under the fear of death. Means just like a fish is surrounded by the water. Everywhere, every time. Similarly, living entity has been closed and surrounded by the fear of death everywhere, wherever he goes. Mrityur matsya nam udake yatha. And still we are so much infatuated with this elements of material body. And that is what Lord Krishna, the purpose of all these stories, if you see, Krishna in previous chapter described the philosophy of Sankhya and elements of material nature. So wealth is a non-living object of a material creation. Still, it can infatuate. Sense object, which is higher than the gross dead objects like wealth. And a sense object, like here for Pururava Maharaj, Urvashi. And for Pingla, all other men. They are the creation of material elements. And worship of self. Creation of material elements. They will bring dukkha, shok and bhaya. So when we start worshipping this, elements of material nature, the creation of Krishna's, It will bring all these things. So therefore, one has to get rid of this infatuation. One time, a lady, an old lady, bus was going, and a lady got into the bus, and all the seats were full. Even a reservation, like reserved for old people, they were also full with, because other old people were sitting. And bus was moving, so, and she was standing. So driver saw that. Arey, budhi aurat hai, so we'll make something. So he told her that please sit on the bonnet. Oh, bonnet hota hai, means engine ke upar na ek case hota hai. So usko bonnet kehte hai. So aur niche se wo garam garam lagta hai, oh, lekin there is a space where you can sit. That is bonnet. So she sat, and bus started moving. So after a few stops, you know, still bus was filled. So one young lady entered in the bus, and bus was full, so there was no space. So immediately, 2-3 people got up, and they started offering her, "Arey, please sit, please sit." Huh? But she felt shy, ki arey kaise baithu kar kar. And so she was not ready to sit. तो वो शर्माने लगी, वो खड़ी रह गई वहीं पर. तो उधर से बूढ़ी औरत बोल रही कि अरे अरे बैठ जा बैठ जा, कुछ दिनों के बाद तो बोनेट पर ही बैठना पड़ेगा. सो पंचेन्द्रियस्य मर्तस्य छिद्रम चेकम इंद्रियस्य ततोस्य श्रवती प्रज्ञा दृत्ते पात्र दिवोदकम. दैट द मटेरियल बॉडी is like a pot with the crack. जब जैसे मटके का घड़ा होता है, उसमें अगर crack बड़ा भी नहीं रहा, एक छोटा सा अगर crack रहा, so it drips away, it takes away all the water. Similarly, the human body, the material body, is designed with the crack, which takes away all your skill, all your beauty, all your assets, which you feel proud of. Prajna dritte patro divodakam. Atha paschati kim ruddhe patitam tam kim bhuvi rere murkhana janasi tarunyam gatamauktikam. Are, one young boy, he asked an old lady, because she was hunchback, means she was seeing downward. So he asked her, "Arey, adha paschati kim, kya dekh rahi ho niche tum? Kya dhund rahi ho?" Means he was making fun of her. So the lady, she told that, "Arey, rere murka, oh foolish boy, don't you know? I have lost my the most precious jewel of my youth. Patro divodakam, just like a full, we have in our DT kitchen, there is a pot made of a clay pot. Usme agar ek chota sa, just crack is there, even it is not visible. If you fill up the water by morning, it will be emptied. So this material body is like that. And that is what here Guru Rava Maharaj is making us realize, that we will lose all our jewels which we are proud of. So better to take a shelter of real jewel, which Guru Maharaj says, "I have got the real diamond," instead of taking shelter of such thing. So Krishna's dealing is very interesting. Here we see that in life of King Pururava, he was like unknown, means from Krishna's point of view, means these things keep going on, isn't it? Why Krishna decided, means how Krishna dealt with this? Krishna did not judge Pururava Maharaj when he was fully, like, infatuated and lost everything when Urvashi was there. Krishna did not, for him it did not matter much. So Krishna never, like, he will never offer you comforts. What you want, and most of the time, if you want any material object, any sense enjoyment, he will not facilitate that much. What he facilitated growth. Instead of giving comfort, he facilitated living entities' growth in Krishna consciousness. And that is the master stroke Krishna always plays. So he did not offer, Pururava Maharaj Urvashi. He did not offer the best of the places. He did not take away miseries from Pururava's life by offering what he desired. What he offered growth for Pururava Maharaj. And when he saw that he is really growing, then he glorified him in this chapter. And how he grew, Pururava Maharaj, then the lessons which he taught through this song. So I'll quickly summarize the five lessons which Pururava Maharaj discussed, five realization. The first he said, if we want to have a material pleasure, the material pleasure is insignificant. Shullakaha. If you see this chapter in the beginning, till this verse. First he says, Shullakaha. It is insignificant in nature, but significant in giving pain. It's not that 1 year or 2 years or some 100 years he was with Urvashi. No, for years and years together, millenniums together, if you read, Urvashi was with him. But he said, the whatever enjoyment I derived, it was a shullakaha, insignificant. That is the nature of material pleasure. How much you receive, it remains insignificant. Shullakaha. And it is potential to give significant pain. The second thing which he talks about, it expands our illusion. Moha vistaraha. So, what is illusion? Illusion basically means a source of suffering you consider is a source of happiness. And you remain stuck over there. Or you keep hanging on to it. That is illusion. That source of suffering. Body is a source of suffering. But we keep casually, keep pampering. So that is the illusion. So that is what? That material pleasure creates illusion and it becomes bigger and bigger over the period. So moha vistara, that is the second thing is talk. Third thing you talk about, vismriti. Means you forget how time is passing. You do not realize. And he says that, I was so much infatuated with her that I did not realize how time has passed. And when someone marries with the illusion and divorces the reality, you do not realize what is happening. So now, what is happening with Pururava Maharaj? He is divorcing the illusion and marrying the reality. So that is the third thing. You do not realize how time has passed. Lifetime after lifetime. He kept saying, I am yours. And Urvashi, she kept saying, no, you are not mine. One time, His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj was saying, only once if we say sincerely, Krishna, I am yours. Krishna is ready to accept, saying, you are mine. Mamai vamsha jiv loke. You are mine only. So he's ready to accept. So we do not realize when time is passing. Vismruti happens of our reality. And the fourth thing he says that it made me lachar. I did not find a very equivalent word in English, a dependent or destitute, but it doesn't give that, but he says that I became lachar, means chahiye, isn't it? So that material pleasure makes one destitute. And the fifth one means kridamurga. He says that I became a kridamurga. I was Chakravarti, but I became a kridamurga. And the fifth one, he says that it makes one shameless. So this is the nature, this real, and therefore Krishna is talking about him, that he came to the conclusion, what he spoke in Bhagavad Gita. These five things, Lord Krishna has already spoken in Bhagavad Gita. And in this Gita also, in Uddhava Gita. So Lord Krishna is demonstrating through Pururava, Maharaj Pururava, that this is what one has to come to the conclusion. Whether male body, female body, whichever body you are in. And finally, so how this, when we have received this material body, which is full of all these substances, but how this body can become worshipable? Because this is the only vehicle we have which can be used in the service of the Lord. So, King Kulshekar, Maharaj Kulshekar, talks about this. So he instructs his each and every senses. Now all our senses are running in all directions. Then he instructs each and every of the senses. Jive kirtaya keshavoyam mururipum cheto bhaje shridharam pani dvanda samarpita chutakatha shrotadravya tum shunu krishnaya lokaya lochanadvaya harer gachhangri yugmalayam. That each and every sense can be engaged in the service of the Lord. Jivve kirtaya keshavoyam. Oh my tongue, please recite the glories of Lord Krishna. Oh my mind, please think about Lord Mura, who is the killer of Mura demon, Murari. Cheto bhaje Sridharam, and worship Lord Sridhar. Jigra grana mukunda pada tulasim murdhannam adokshajam. Oh nose, please smell the flower or the tulsi buds which are offered at the lotus feet of the Lord. And oh my legs, be useful going to the holy abode, temple of the Lord. So in this way, if we engage our senses, then we need not have to be fearful in this material world. If we keep engaging ourselves in this material world, in the service of the Lord, in the service of the devotee, then the same body which is source of illusion, which is source of abominable activities, can become worshipable. And that is what, again, Kulshekar Maharaj says that, Yat Krishna Pranipat Duli Davalam Tad Varshma Tad Vaishiras Te Netre Tamasojite Suruchire Yabhyam Harira Drishyate Sabuddhir Vimalendu Shanka Davala Yamadavadhyayini Sajivamrita Varshini Pratipadam Yastoti Narayanam. So bhakti gradually spiritualizes and beautifies all our senses. And they become worshipable. Here, Kulshekar Maharaj is saying that eyes are worshipable who has abandoned the ignorance and is engaged in the taking darshan of the Lord. Sadrishyate. That head is worshipable. Of that person's head is worshipable who is always bowing down in front of the Lord, or who has been smeared by the dust of the lotus feet of the devotees and the Lord. Yat Krishna Pranipad Dhuli Dhavalam. And that buddhi, that intelligence is worshipable if it is constantly remembering the Lord. Sya Madhava Dhyayini. When your intelligence is remembering Krishna, remembering Madhava, then that intelligence is worshipable. And Sa Jiva, this Jiva will exude nectar. It will give nectar unlimited, which living entity is looking for. When we engage this Jiva in glorifying or taking the holy name of the Lord, in glorifying the pastimes of the Lord, then this body, which could be a source of suffering, becomes the source of worship. Then this body becomes the vehicle going back home, back to God. And that is what the purpose of this chapter. That after singing this song, King Pururava, Maharaj Pururava, from a Gandharva Loka, he went back home, back to God. And therefore, it is Punya Kirtayaha. So I'll stop here. Kindly forgive me if anything which I have spoken beyond my realization and which might have hurt anyone or anything. So kindly forgive me. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, Jai Nitai Gaura Premanande. So, if anyone has any question, he can come and personally ask me.